Millie and me. I think Millie's having a daddy moment. I think she's having a daddy moment. Are you happy? Oh, things moving. That thing's moving. What's up with that, huh? What's up with that? There we go. I think they want to see more of you. Your face is prettier than mine. Your face is prettier than mine. Aren't you happy, kitty? Huh? Are you a happy kitty? Yes, you're a happy kitty. Millie just had her fix of catnip. And a full plate of fancy feast. Turkey and cheese, I think it was. Is that what it was? Was it good? Was it good? Oh, what a nice kitty. Oh, what a nice kitty. Love you. Love you. Oh, yeah. I love you. So I'm having a Millie moment. Either that or Millie's having a daddy moment. One of the two. And this is my little rescue kitty that I rescued about three years now. When I found her, somebody had dropped her off to the streets of Holyoke. She found her way into the studio I play music in this big old mill, and she was eating off of whatever somebody was feeding her and whatever mice she could catch. She was very scared, very wild, and I think she had been abused. She didn't trust anybody. And kind of took care of her there for a while. Cut a hole in my studio wall, a rehearsal space wall, rather, really much of a studio, so she could come in and out as she wanted, and kept her food there all the time. And then one day I'd gone there, and something had happened to her. I don't know if she got hurt or somebody hurt her. There were so many people in the daytime. It was a industrial mill during the day, dead at night, you know. And I don't know if somebody was mean to her, or she got hurt. Some guy had a dog running around there in the day. Maybe that got a hold of her. But she was really fucked up. Like, she had a concussion and stuff. And actually thought she was going to die. Well, I kind of took care of her. And eventually I brought her home here because I just felt like she shouldn't be living in that place anymore. And she's been the best cat I've ever had. The most loyal. She'll literally fight for everybody in the family, you know. I mean, if somebody's messing with me, man, she'll jump on their back. She's a good cat. Cat's got my back. And she shows her loyalty in moments like this. We go out for our morning walks every morning. I got a leash for her. She's like a little doggy. And she's really good. Not really. I couldn't do this a little while ago, but look at that tail. Isn't that the most, I don't know if you can see that or not. That's the most beautiful powder puff right on the end. Black. Striped up like a raccoon. Got beautiful. Beautiful markings. She usually bites me when I do that, but she's been getting a lot better now. She likes to just kind of bury right into me here. She's a good old kitty. She's my good old kitty. As you can see, she's got her paw clutched right onto my shirt there. She's a real touchy-feely kitty. It's kind of cool. She's a good animal. Good animal. Quiet, clean, loyal. Don't eat too much. She likes her catnip. And she likes music. She's a music-loving pussycat. Bye.